you've done that, will you go upstairs and tell Mrs. Manningham I wish to see her down here?
Yes, sir. Certainly, sir.
Well, Nancy.
Says she has a headache, sir, and is trying to sleep.
Oh, she still has a headache, has she?
Yes, sir. Is there anything more you want, sir?
Did you ever know a time when Mrs. Manningham did not have a headache, Nancy?
No, sir. Hardly ever, sir.
Do you usually perform your domestic tasks in outdoor costume?
No, sir. I told you. I've only just come in and I heard the bell by chance.
Yes, that's just my turn.
How do you mean, sir?
If you come closer, I can see, Nancy. Have you any idea of the time of day, or rather, night, Nancy?
It's a little after 11.
And are you aware that you can take half a minute or even less before myself?
I thought I saw you, sir.
Oh, you thought you saw me. Well, I certainly saw you.
Did you, sir?
Have you ever reflected, Nancy, you're given a great deal of latitude in this household?
I don't know, sir. I don't know what latitude means.
Latitude, Nancy, means considerable liberty. Liberty to the extent of 2 nights off a week.
Yes, sir.
Well, that's all very well. It's not so well, however, when you return as late as the master of the house. We ought to keep up some pretenses, you know.
Yes, sir. We must.
Nancy.
Yes.
What the devil have you been tonight, anyway?
Only with some friends.
You know, Nancy, when you say friends, I have an extraordinary idea that you mean gentlemen friends.
Well, sir, possibly I might.
You know, gentlemen friends have been known to take decided liberties with young ladies such as yourself. Are you alive to such a possibility?
No, sir. Not me. I can look after myself.
You're always so anxious to look after yourself.
No, sir, not always, perhaps.
You know, Nancy, it's pretty as your bonnet. There's nothing near so pretty as your hair beneath it. Won't you take it off and let me see?
It comes off easy enough. There. Is there anything more you want, sir?
Yes, possibly. Come here, will you?
What do you want, huh? What do you want? There! Can she do that for you? Can she do that?
What can you be talking about, Nancy?
You know who I mean, all right?
Now, Nancy, you're a very remarkable girl in many respects. I believe you are jealous of your mistress.
She? She's a poor thing. There's no need to be jealous of her. You want to kiss me again, don't you? Don't you want to kiss me? That's better, isn't it? Better than a sick headache and a pale face all the day.
Yes, Nancy, I believe it is. I think, however, don't you, it would be better if you and I met one evening in different better go. I have some work to do.
No, I don't want to go.
And now run along. I have some work to do.
Work? What are you going to work at? What are you going to do?
Well, first, I'm going to write some letters. Never mind. Go on, Nancy. There's a